Hi everyone! Today's video is going to be a step-by-step instruction of how to use Edpuzzle in your classroom, specifically with a concentration on e-learning via Edpuzzle. So the first thing obviously you need to do is to create an account with Edpuzzle. And once you have done so, I recommend you go up to the top right-hand corner and click on My Classes to set up your students and your classes on the Edpuzzle site. As you can see, I have classes already set up here, ready to go, and I did that very easily by setting up through Google Classroom, as you can see through the little Google Classroom icon here. You can do the same, which I recommend, by clicking Add New Class, and as you see, there's a little drop-down for Google Classroom. If you click that link, it will allow you the ability to sync all of your Google Classroom classes, as well as all of the students who are in them. If you assign an assignment via Edpuzzle, you can also post it into Google Classroom as an assignment from this site. And not only that, but students will be able to sign into the Edpuzzle site and complete your assignment just by logging in with the email they have linked to that Google Classroom class. Once you have linked all of your classrooms and students, you're going to now focus on the content you would like to assign to them. So we're going to click on the Content tab up in the top right-hand corner. There are lots of ways to assign content in Edpuzzle, but we're going to focus on the two that I feel are most useful right now, which is either using YouTube videos that you have found and like, or using your own content via videos that you have created that you would like to upload to Edpuzzle. So first, let's start with YouTube. Obviously, with e-learning, you don't want to reinvent the wheel for everything. You don't need to create brand new content when so many people have already done so on YouTube and have great instructional videos that you can use to your advantage. I recommend by starting off by searching for people that you know have great content on YouTube. For example, as a Spanish teacher, Señor Jordan is a great resource that we use in the classroom all the time, as well as other teachers. So for example, if I know I'm doing a lesson on tener, I can go ahead and click this video right here, and I can use that one and create questions to make sure my students have watched this video, as well as making sure that they understand the information being taught in that video. If you can't find the video that you're looking for right here, no worries, because at the top you can see if you can't find a certain video through this page, you can go ahead and copy and paste directly from YouTube the link of the video that you want to use that you already have found and find to be useful for this particular topic. For example, if I know I specifically want to focus on weirdo verbs with the present subjunctive, I can go ahead and open up this video, copy the link, and paste it right into this bar. And now it brings me directly to that YouTube video and allows me to use it for my Edpuzzle assignment. So when you are going into a specific video that you now know you want to use, it brings you to this page, which is your editing page for each video. So you have a couple of options. The first is you can cut the video. As you can see, it tells you that this will save you time by cutting out pieces of the video that you do not feel are relevant or useful for your student learning. So for example, if the video is super long and you don't want your students to watch a 6-minute video because maybe it has an explanation that your students already know, you can go ahead and trim the video so that way you don't have to have them watch all of this information that's not going to help them. The second tool you can use is voiceover. So say, for example, you really want to use the information in this Señor Jordan video, but you don't like the way he explains it. Maybe you want to speak specifically to your students and previous knowledge they have, or maybe you want to teach the video in Spanish and he instructs in English. You can start recording your own voiceover over an already pre-existing YouTube video to teach it the way you would teach it to your students in the classroom. Lastly, and I think the most useful feature, is questions. So while your students are watching the video, you can insert questions during the video to make sure your students are comprehending what is being instructed. I think the most useful and the best one is to use the multiple choice question, because once you assign a multiple choice question within the video, you already are allowed to choose the correct answer and students get feedback immediately as to whether or not they did understand the content of the video or maybe they need to rewatch and understand it better. Open-ended questions are great as well. However, they need to be scored independently by you, and the students do not receive that independent feedback right away. And notes are just little ways to add your own commentary throughout the video. Perhaps if you chose not to do the voiceover option, but you still want to make a little note to your students like, hey, remember we talked about this last week? You can go ahead and insert a note to your students at any point during the video as well. Now I'm going to quickly show you what it looks like to insert a video question. So I'm going to watch the video. I'm watching it on silent right now, so that way it's not conflicting with me giving the instruction. But perhaps maybe during this point in the video, I decide I want to ask a question. And I could say, what does the E in weirdo stand for? And I would put my correct answer first. And then you can go ahead and include other answers. And you can add as many as you would like in here. And obviously these are silly answers. And it's quite obvious what the correct answer is. You obviously would want to use comprehension questions that might be a little bit more challenging for your students. But once you feel good about that, you can save it. Please note as well, you can also add feedback. So maybe if this was a like red herring answer or very close to the correct answer, you could say, close, but actually eggs would deal with a breakfast question, of course. And then once the students answer, if they chose that, they would get that feedback once they're done. And so you can insert questions like this throughout the entire video. And like I said, you can pause at any time and you can insert any type of question out of these three. You can do more multiple choice. You can do an open-ended, but like I said, it does not get instantly graded. Or you can add in like a little footnote to your students. And as you see, once a question has been added, it makes this little teardrop icon so you know that it's been placed in that part of the video. So if I feel comfortable with this video, I can go ahead and click finish. And now I can choose to assign it to my classes. I can go back in and edit it if I realize it's not been completed the way I want. I can duplicate it and maybe make a more challenging video for an honors class or an AP class with the same kind of material. Or I can realize that it's not what I want and I can go ahead and delete it. And as you will see, once you have created questions, it will show you on the side here what the students have to complete by the end of the video. For this particular one, we only created one multiple choice question that was at the 1 minute mark. And so that would be all they needed to do by the end of watching that video. If I were going to assign this video because I feel that I like it, I can click on assign, and as you see, I have students and classes here already set up via Google Classroom like we talked about before. So if it has that little classroom icon, that means it's already been set up through Classroom and it will immediately post to Google Classroom if you choose this link right here, and I'll show you that in a second. Or this is a class that I set up that is not linked through Google Classroom, and so it does not have the classroom icon and I cannot post it to Google Classroom via this site. So you can go ahead and pick a due date. So maybe I want to do it today at midnight. I save it. And then one of my favorite parts is you can choose this option, which is prevent skipping. So if you have students who are not watching the instructional videos and are therefore not understanding the assessments, this is a great way you could make a small 5-point assignment of just, did you watch the video? Because students cannot skip through the video and it will record and show you the progress of how much of the video they actually watched. You can also choose whether or not it has captions on. And then if you're choosing to put it into a class that is with Google Classroom, you can link it so that it does post directly into Classroom for you and it creates it as an assignment and it will alert your students when that has been done. So we're just going to assign it to this class. And again, you can choose whether you want to assign it to all the students or you can choose which students it's going to go to. So we're going to click assign. And there you go. Now our assignment is put in there and we do not have to worry about it. And this is what the progress will look like once you go into your page. As you can see, this is a new assignment and I'm the only student that's in here. So you can see I have not watched any percent of the video. I do not have a grade because I did not complete the questions. I have not watched it and I have not turned it in. So that's a really nice feature and I'll show you what that looks like once a student has completed it in a minute. Now, maybe you don't want to use a video that's on YouTube or some other site. Maybe you have an amazing Google Slides presentation that you have used every year of your teaching and you do not want to deviate and you really want to teach it in your own words to your kids the way you know they understand it. So you can still do that. We're going to go back to content And in order to do this option, you have to have pre-recorded yourself teaching this content. My favorite way to do so is with the site that I'm using right now to show you this instructional, which is through the Google Chrome extension of screencastify.com. It's a really easy way to use to record your own screen and to talk over it. You can even include your face in it if you would like. And it records it, and you can upload it as a YouTube video, or you can upload it into Google Classroom, or just save the video, whatever you want to do. So I'm going to show you a video that I created myself. So we go into my content. Here is a video that I created earlier today. So this is a video that I made on Screencastify that is just a Google Slides presentation that I made. And in this recording, I am clicking through the presentation and I am talking over it in Spanish. And I'm using this as a listening comprehension activity. So as my students listen to the activity, they have to go in, and you can see there's a multiple choice question here based off of what they would have heard, and they have to answer the question. This gives you a little bit of a demonstration of what it looks like from the student end if they are assigned a video. So if perhaps I didn't hear the question of why I make the bed, I can click rewatch, and then it will play that same clip from the last question or the beginning of the video to when that multiple choice question is. So I'm like, oh, I heard it there. Oh, okay. It's because of this. And I can submit it. And great. I get that immediate feedback that I was correct. I got 100 and I can keep going. And so this is a great way to have your own content on Edpuzzle. It is a video of you teaching on a PowerPoint, or you can record yourself talking, and then you can insert questions throughout that video and assign that to your students for them to complete. The way you would be able to create that is you would go into content, and you can go into my content, and you can click add content, and you can create a video. So you can create a video, or what I recommend is you do that previous video recording of yourself teaching and you upload it there. And then once you have done so, it would immediately bring you back to that same editing screen we saw before with the YouTube videos, where you can insert questions that are multiple choice, open-ended, or a note to your students. So I'm going to go into my gradebook now to show you what it looks like once you have finished an assignment and a student has completed it. So I'm going to go down to my test class. And as you can see, here is my gradebook, and here is my only student, which is me. And so you can see here are the different videos that have been assigned to that class. So I have only done one of the assignment, and my running average right now is in 100 because I have 100 on one video. But I also have two other videos that I have not completed yet. So I can go and see, okay, great, Christy got 100 on the video. Let's see a little bit closer what that looks like. So I got 100. I watched 100% of the video. I answered all 6 of the questions. I spent 2 minutes doing it, and it was turned in at this exact time. And then you can go down even further, and you can see exactly what I answered on each one. And you can even see here too, on this question, I added a comment and said, ooh, this one was tricky. This is a great way for you to go through and make sure that your students are understanding the content. Or even, like I said before, if you just want to verify that your students are watching the materials that you're putting into Google Classroom, this is an easy way to do it because it forces them to sit through the video. You can see through this spreadsheet exactly how much percent of each of the videos the students watched to be sure that they're completing it, they're answering the questions if you put them in there, and when they actually did that, so that way you can be sure. And what's nice is that if you prevent the skipping, like we showed over here, that means that if they watch 100% of the video, that video was 100% watched. They cannot skip through it, just to be sure that they get that grade. So that's your crash course on Edpuzzle. I hope that it was useful for you. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments.